Good morning, children. We are continuing the same exercise, exercise 7.3 from chapter 7, triangles. Question number 2. AD is an altitude of an isosceles triangle ABC in which AB equal to AC. Show that AD bisects BC and AD bisects angle A. Very easy sum compared to the previous sum and all. So what is given in the question? Isosceles triangle. AD is an altitude. So angle D equal to 90 degree. AB and AC are equal. To prove, two parts are there. The first one, AD bisects BC. If AD bisects BC, means what we should get? BD equal to DC. Next, is AD bisects angle A. The line AD bisects angle A means these two angles are equal. So the second part we can write as angle BAD equal to angle CAD. These to be proved. So proof, in triangle ABD and triangle ACD. Okay, what is the equal side? AB equal to AC, right? We already marked the equal side, that is given. Okay, next, angle D equal to, angle D equal to 90, that is also given. And see that one, angle D is 90 degree. This side AB that we have written as a opposite to 90 degree, that means hypotenuse. It is hypotenuse. And it is right angle we got. Now one more side we need RHS criteria. So AD common we can take. AD equal to AD common. So side. When we are taking the sides, equal angle. First we have to compare only in one triangle. So ABD we will consider first. Okay, ABD, angle D is 90, AB is hypotenuse. See that one, angle D 90 means once 90 got the first step, that whether it is a RHS criteria we should see. So 90 degree opposite side which will come the side AB only. So side AB is also given as equal side, one of the equal sides. So hypotenuse we got. Now one more side we required, that is AD equal to AD common. Therefore, triangle ABD is congruent to, for D it is D only. Now AB and AC, which is the letter common here? AB and the AD, first and the third. Now we have to compare, see first and third, A is common. Similarly first and third, which is common? A. So in place of A it is A only. In place of D we got D. Then for B the correspondence is with the C. So triangle ABD congruent to triangle ACD, the criteria is RHS. This is simple only for proving this congruency. Now the still the proof is not completed. So what is the CPCT from here? BD equal to CD CPCT. Next, angle BAD equal to BAD, order is this one, equal to angle CAD. Again CPCT. Okay, so these two criteria, this is proved one, this is proved two. Proved one and proved two. Now I repeat once again, triangle ABD and triangle ACD, the equal side is AB equal to AC. Again, angle D equal to angle D 90 degree. These two criteria are given in the question. Now we require, by this we got one right angle hypotenuse. So what is remaining? One more side. So for that we are taking the common side, AD equal to AD. By using this, triangle ABD congruent to triangle ACD, RHS criteria. By this what you can write? CPCT we can write. BD equal to CD CPCT. The first one, proved first part. That means AD bisects BC. Clear? Angle BAD equal to angle CAD. CPCT again. what is the reason for this one? Well, by this what we can write a proof, the second part. AD bisects angle A we got. Angle A equal to angle A. That means AD bisects angle A. So by CPCT, we can prove that BD equal to CD by means that AD bisects BC and angle BAD equal to angle CAD CPCT. By this, we can conclude that AD bisects angle A, hence proved. Two sides AB and BC and median AM of one triangle ABC and respectively equal to the sides PQ, QR and median PN of the triangle PQR. Show that triangle ABM congruent to triangle PQN. And also we have to prove triangle ABC congruent to triangle PQR. So what is given in the question? Given in the question means AB and BC. AB this side and BC second side, that is base, and median AM, that is the third side. So this is the first side we will take, second side and third side, right? So these are equal to correspondingly PQ. So AB equal to PQ and QR. QR means the base here. Okay, what is the third side? Median PN are equal to each other. Then what we have to prove? Triangle ABM congruent to triangle PQN. And similarly, triangle ABC congruent to triangle PQR. If we go for the second proof, ABC and PQR, what will have equal side? AB equal to PQ, the first equal side. BC equal to QR, the second equal side. But we don't have any third side for triangle ABC. See that one, the big the triangle ABC we are taking, the first equal side we have marked and the second equal side we have marked, but the third one marked is not a side of ABC, it is AM only, right? So either we should get a third side or a angle. So we will not get the third side will be AC only, so we should get angle. So what we should do means first we will prove triangle ABM and a PQN. So I'll write here AB equal to PQ, the given part, and BC equal to QR, and AM equal to PN. To prove both the criteria, triangle ABM congruent to triangle PQN and the second one, triangle ABC congruent to triangle PQR. Now proof. So which are the triangle we have to consider in triangle ABM? Triangle ABM and a triangle PQN. Okay. Triangle ABM and PQN, we can write that AB equal to PQ, AM equal to PN. Two sides we already got, that is given. But for getting third side, what we should do? What is the third side of the triangle ABM? AB the first side we have taken, AM as the second side we have taken, then BM we need. So for getting BM, what we should consider means already it is given that BC equal to QR. Right? BC equal to QR implies half of BC equal to half of QR. Why we are taken half? Because AM and PN are medians. What is given in the question? AM and PN are medians. That means this became M and N are midpoints. Right? AM and PN are medians. Right? They are median means M and N are midpoints. This is the knowledge for you here, not required to write in the proof. Now we have written half BC equal to half QR. What is the meaning of half BC means? Half BC means either I can write BM or MC. Similarly, QN and NR. So we need BM because this is the triangle we are considering ABM only. This implies BM equal to QN. So I'll write the third side as BM equal to QN. Now the reason I have written here, therefore triangle ABM is congruent to triangle PQN by SSS criteria. Triangle ABM congruent to triangle PQN SSS triple S. So proved first part. Now for second part, in triangle ABC and triangle PQR. Okay. Now by this what we can write, that CPCT I have not written for this SSS criteria, angle B equal to angle Q CPCT. This should be used for the next criteria. In triangle ABC and triangle PQR, AB equal to PQ, BC equal to QR. We already explained this point because the two sides we got included angle we should get. So for this, the CPCT we should use. So angle B is equal to angle Q. Now here, these two reason is given only. The two sides are equal, they are only given, one median, right? So given is only angle B equal to angle Q using 1. So side and this is included angle. So triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR SAS. Proved second one, right? So proved second part also we have done, but the two different criteria we have used for the first one SSS, that is triple S, and the second one it is SAS. I repeat the proof. Two sides and one median are equal to the other two sides and one median of the other triangle, right? So two sides, first side and the second side, third side is the median. So for proving triangle ABM and triangle PQN, we will take triangle ABM, first side and the second side we got. For getting third side, what we had done? BC equal to QR, half of BC equal to half of QR. I have written the reason here, AM and PN are medians. That means M and N are midpoints. So BC divided into two equal halves, similarly QR. So BM equal to CM as well as QN equal to NR. So that means BM and QN only we required here. So the three sides, see, the first side is AB, second side is AM, and the third side is BM. So by SSS criteria, these two triangles are congruent and proved the first part. From this, what we write, angle B equal to angle Q. So for the triangle ABC and PQR, already we are having two sides are equal. So included angle required. So the included angle we are getting from CPCT criteria. So AB equal to PQ, BC equal to QR, angle B equal to angle Q, that is the included angle. Therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR by SAS criteria. Hence, fourth question, BE and CF are two equal altitudes. So BE is equal to CF. So we got two altitudes are also equal. Altitude means what will happen? Angle E and angle F became 90 degree. So the two equal criteria is given. One is angle, another one is a side. That angle is also 90 degree. So we should go for RHS criteria only, because the question itself, it is clearly asked that using RHS criteria, that the triangle ABC is isosceles. So we will write here, given BE equal to CF, angle E equal to angle F equal to 90 degrees in altitude, to prove triangle ABC is isosceles. Now proof. So BE is one of the side we should take, BC. We will take triangle BEC and triangle CFB. Right. In triangle BEC, which are the equal side, we will write B side only. So BE equal to CF equal to given. to equal altitude they are given. Now angle equal to angle F is equal to 90 since altitude property, that is also given. Now this is 90 degree and this is side we got. So this is right angle and this is side we can. Now the, what is the opposite side hypotenuse is, let us see. Because BE as a side we have taken, angle E as a 90. So angle E is 90 means the opposite side is which one? BC. So we will write BC for this triangle. Similarly, we will check for CFB. It is also applicable. CFB, we have taken the side as CF and the 90 degree as F. So the side opposite to 90 degree is again BC only. So BC equal to BC common. So here also side. No, here we should write hypotenuse, right? So R right angle, HY hypotenuse, S is side only. Therefore, the triangle BEC is the order I have taken. For E, it is F. So the middle letter is F. Right, next B and CF. So E correspondence with the F only. For B, what is the corresponding letter? C. So CFB is the order and the criteria is RHS. Since it is asked in the question, we should use that only. So it is CFB. Okay, RHS criteria we got. These two triangles are congruent. Now what is to be proved here? Because the triangle ABC is isosceles. Now you tell me, in BEC the angle C is coming, complete angle is angle C, B is half only, see this much only B is coming. So I'll write here angle BCE equal to BCE equal to CBF. Now check CBF means CBF, that the complete angle is coming. It should not be marked, this is a CPCT only for your understanding purpose only I have marked. For because the when we are taking the angle, it should be a complete angle. So I have to write a BCE, that only this angle, and a CBF, this angle, because it is CPCT, right? Now by CPCT, these two angles are equal. That means, that is angle C equal to angle B implies. What is the opposite side to angle C? It is AB. What is the opposite side to angle B? It is AC. This shows that triangle ABC is isosceles. Hence, proved. Two equal altitudes and given here. So that means BE and CF are equal to each other. Angle equal to angle F equal to 90 degree. So we got right angle and one side. So for getting the hypotenuse, we should choose the triangle correctly. So BEC we have taken. So the side opposite to 90 degree is BC. In the second angle CFB also BC is coming common. So we got right angle, hypotenuse, side, and these two triangles are congruent. Now we have to prove that the triangle is isosceles. By this we are writing the CPCT, angle C is equal to angle B. Sometimes children, what will write, they have to prove that angle B and C only, directly they will write angle B for this triangle, but angle B is not coming full here, so we should write angle C only for this side, that is BEC. Angle C is equal to angle B, then only opposite side we can take, that is AB equal to AC, then two sides are equal, therefore triangle ABC is isosceles. ABC is an isosceles triangle with AB equal to AC, and draw AB perpendicular to BC, show that angle B equal to angle C. If this is the question, nothing to be proved. Y means triangle ABC is isosceles triangle and two sides are equal. So AB equal to AC, then the opposite angles are definitely equal only. So nothing to be proved, we can prove like easily only. That is, the real proof is this much only. If AB equal to AC implies angle C equal to angle B, hence proved. But the question will change in exam. Using RHS criteria, we have to prove. using RHS criteria, we have to prove or show that angle B equal to angle C. So if question changes like this, then only the proof comes. Otherwise, this is only the proof. So given AB equal to AC, to prove angle B equal to angle C. So proof: in triangle APB and triangle APC, angle P is equal to angle P equal to 90 degree, so right angle AB equal to AC given. Okay, AP equal to AP common. Triangle APB is congruent to triangle APC, RHS. This is 90 degree. AB is hypotenuse. This is side. Right, so triangle APB congruent to triangle APC, then we can write angle B equal to angle C by CPCT, hence proved. So when the question is asked in the first method, there is only one line we have to write: AB equal to AC, since it is isosceles triangle, base angles are equal. But the same question, it can ask in the question paper, using RHS criteria, we have to prove angle B equal to angle C. So what we should take? Angle P is 90 degrees already given, and AB and AC are equal, that is the hypotenuse, and AP is a common side. So RHS criteria, these two triangles are congruent. Now what is the base angle? APB, which angle is coming? Angle B. And ACB, angle C is coming. So angle B equal to angle C, we have proved. With this, today's class I am winding up. Thank you.